Hello learners, my name is Dr. Priya Mahajan and today we are discussing about the industrial policy. Learners, after getting independence, India needed to revive economy from a completely crumbled state. The country had many tasks in front of it, the abject mass poverty, shortage of food grains, healthcare, etc. and they are calling for immediate attention. Other areas of attention included industry, infrastructure, science and technology, and higher education and more. Increasing the growth of economy was the urgent need of the time. Looking at the available options, India decided that the industrial sector should be the prime moving force of the economy. So the industrial policy which the government announced from time to time basically molded the very nature and structure of the economy. The concept of industrial policy is comprehensive and covers all those principles, policies, rules and regulations that control the industrial undertakings of a country and shape the pattern of industrialization. It incorporates fiscal and monetary policies, tariff policy, labor policy, and the government attitude not only towards external assistance but also towards the public and private sector. After independence, India has released industrial policies around six times. These are Industrial Policy 1948, Industrial Policy 1956, Industrial Policy 1977, Industrial Policy 1980, Industrial Policy 1990, and Industrial Policy 1991. Among these industrial policies, the policies of 1948, 56, and 1991 were very important, whereas the industrial policy of 1977, 1980 and 1990 was the further extension of previous policies. So we will discuss each of these policy one by one. The first industrial policy announced was the Industrial Policy Resolution 1948. The major highlights of these policies were India will be a mixed economy, means both public and private sector will participate equally for the development of the economy. Second, some of the important industries were put under the central list, such as coal, power, railways, civil aviation, arms and ammunition, defense, etc. Third, some other industries, usually of medium category, were put under a state list, such as paper, medicines, textiles, cycles, rickshaws, two-wheelers, etc. Fourth, rest of the industries not covered by either the central or the state list were left open for the private sector investment, with many of them having the provision of compulsory licensing. And fifth one is there was a 10-year period for review of the policy. After the positive impact of the industrial policy 1948, the government announced the new and more crystallized policy for the Indian industries. The industrial policy of 1956 was announced after the 8 years of first policy. The new industrial policy of 1956 enlarged the role of private sector. The major provision of this policy was, first one is the reservation of industry. Industries were classified under three schedules, Schedule A, Schedule B, and Schedule C. Schedule A had 17 industrial area in which the center was given complete monopoly. The industries set up under these provisions were known as the Central Public Sector Undertakings, CPSUs, which later getting popularity as PSUs. Then Schedule B. There were 12 industrial areas put under this schedule in which the state governments have the priority of setting up of new units and also would not deny the private sector to set up units or expand existing units. This schedule also carried the provision of compulsory licensing. Then third is Schedule C. All the industrial areas left out of Schedule A and B were put under this, in which the private enterprises had the provision to set up industries. Many of them had the provision of licensing and have necessarily to fit into the framework of the social and economic policy of the state and were subject to control and regulation in terms of the Industrial Development Regulation Act and other relevant legislations. Further, the industrial policy in 1956 for the first time emphasized on the role of the small scale industries in the development of national economy and also pointed out the importance of the small scale industrial sector in providing employment. Next was the industrial policy statement 1977. But before that, in 1969, MRTP Act has been implemented. The objective of this was to regulate the trading and commercial practices of the firms and checking the monopoly and concentration of economic power. And in 1973, to regulate foreign exchange, FERA Act has been implemented. Then in December 1977, the central government announced a new industrial policy by way of a statement in the parliament. The major objective of this policy was the promotion of cottage and small industries in rural areas and small towns. The concept of district industry center was introduced for the first time. As per this policy, each district would have such a district center which would extend all the support and services required by small entrepreneurs. Within the SSI sector, that is small scale industries sector, a new concept of tiny sector was introduced. It was defined as an industrial unit with investment in machinery and equipment of up to rupees 1 lakh and situated in a town of less than 50,000 as per the 1971 census. The items reserved for the small sector was 47 as recommended by the Carbic Committee introduced in 1967. The list of such reserved item was 504 till 1977, and 1977 policy expanded this list to 807. Then came the industrial policy statement of 1980, focused on the need for promoting competition in the domestic market, technological upgradation and modernization. The policy laid the foundation for an increasingly competitive export base and for encouraging foreign investment in high-tech areas. Industrial licensing was simplified to some extent, and also liberal attitude followed towards the expansion of private industries. Learners, until 1991, the scope of private sector industries was very limited because of the importance given to the public sector in the previous industrial policies. Large firms, in particular, were subject to severe restrictions. The industrial policy announced in 24 July 1991 marked the new era in the business environment of India. The past industrial policies had shaped the nature and structure of the Indian economy. The need of the hour was now to change the nature and structure of the economy by early 1990s. For this, the government of India decided to come up with the new industrial policy of 1991. With this policy, the government kick-started the very process of reforms in the economy. That is why the policy is taken more as a process than a policy. Now I will discuss with you the major highlights of new industrial policy of 1991. First one is de-reservation of the industries. Earlier, as per the industrial policy in 1956, 17 industries were reserved for central government. 1991 industrial policy reduced this number to 8. In coming years, many other industries were also opened for private sector investment. At present, there are only 2 industries which are fully or partially reserved for the central government. First is atomic energy and nuclear research, and second is railways. Though many of the functions related to the railways have been allowed private entry, but still the private sector cannot enter the sector as a full-fledged railway service provider. Second is de-licensing of the industries. The Industries Development Regulation Act 1951 gave powers to the central government to regulate the development of industries by imposing licensing system. A license is a written permission from the government to an industrial undertaking to manufacture specified articles included in the schedule to the act. If a new company has to be formed, it was compulsory for it to get the industrial license. The central government was also empowered to regulate the production, quality, supply, price and distribution of product of industrial undertakings. Under this Act of 1951, government can also take over the management of industrial undertakings in the public interest. The industrial policy announced in July 1991 abolished industrial licensing. Now, the number of industries put under the compulsory provision of licensing belonging to the Schedule B and C as per the Industrial Policy Regulation 1956 were cut down to only 18. Reforms regarding the areas were further followed, and presently there are only 5 industries which carry the burden of compulsory licensing. First one is aerospace and defense related electronics. Second, gunpowder, industrial explosive and detonating fuse. Third is dangerous chemicals. Fourth is tobacco, cigarette and related products. Fifth one is alcoholic drinks. So these 5 industries are still under the compulsory licensing. Third is the abolition of MRTP limit. The MRTP Act prevent the expansion of the companies whose asset was 100 crore or more. These companies were termed as MRTP companies, and these companies to take government permission to expand their business. But the new industrial policy in 1991 scrapped this limit, and now the industries need not to take prior approval from the government for investment in the de-licensed industries. In 2002, Competition Act was passed, which has replaced the MRTP Act. The fourth one is promotion of foreign investment. Foreign investment has been regulated in India. Industries has to take special approval from the government for the import of foreign technology as well as the foreign investments. It caused undue delays and government interference and also hampered the business decisions making. Therefore, the new industrial policy prepared a specified list of high technology and high investment priority industries wherein automatic permission was to be made available for direct investment up to 51% foreign equity. Presently, FDI, that is called foreign direct investment, is permitted 100% on the automatic route in most sectors, subject to sectoral rules, regulation applicable. FDI is prohibited only in these areas. These are the retail trading, atomic energy, lottery business, and gambling and betting. Since 1992-93, the Indian stock market is open for investment by foreign institutional investors, that is called FIIs, and Indian companies satisfying certain conditions may access foreign capital market by euro issues. Fifth one is location of industries. Now the industries were classified into polluting and non-polluting categories, and a highly simple provision deciding their location was announced. First one is non-polluting industries might be set up anywhere, and second is polluting industries to be set up at least 25 kilometers away from the cities whose population is more than 1 million. Third one is compulsion to convert loans into shares abolished. In 1969, major banks of the countries were fully nationalized. The private companies who had borrowed capital from these banks, when the banks were privately owned, now wanted their loans to be paid back. The government came up with the idea that those companies who are unable to repay their loans, they could opt to convert their loan amount into equity shares and hand them over to the banks. The private companies which opted this route ultimately became a government-owned company, as the banks were owned by the government of India. So this was the indirect route to nationalize private firm. Such a compulsion which hampered the growth and development of the Indian industry was withdrawn by government in 1991. Now these financial institutions will not impose this mandatory convertibility clause. So this is all about new industrial policy, and learners, you can see that new industrial policy of 1991 has effected some very fundamental policies changes, such as near abolition of licensing, easing of MRTP and FARA Act, reduced list of industries for the public sector, automatic approval of foreign technology agreements and 51% foreign equity participation, private investment in infrastructure. Liberal location policy for industry, free import of capital goods, liberal policy measures for attracting foreign direct investments. The main objective of the liberalized policy measure was to enhance the productivity and competitive efficiency in the industrial sector. So, learner, this is all about this session. Thank you and happy learning.